Homa pale na mtazamaji imeibuka kwamba hospitali ya rufaa na mafunzo ya Moi kule Eldoret inapata wagonjwa wengi zaidi kupita kipimo inachostahiki na hivyo basi kusababisha baadhi ya wagonjwa kutumia kitanda kimoja. Haya yameibuka katika mkao na seneti ambayo inafanya vikao vyake mashinani. Tuvuke kule kwa sasa hivi ambapo Profesa Lukoye Atoli anazungumza zaidi na kutoa mawaidha na hali ilivyo katika hospitali ile kwa seneti. Moja kwa moja.
To ensure smooth running. And if you go to MTRH and look at the directorates, some of the heads of those directorates are actually members of the School of Medicine and the College of Health Sciences. That is how close we are. And so if you're looking for a model of collaboration between an academic institution and a service institution, don't look any further than the relationship we have at the College of Health Sciences and Moi Teaching and Referral Hospital. Having highlighted those successes, and there are many, and we are proud of them, it is my duty as well to highlight some of the challenges that we have experienced over the years as we have grown and as we have developed beyond our initial dreams. I think in collaboration with our local partners, we have achieved a lot in the areas of training, research, and healthcare delivery. However, there are perennial and emerging challenges that put the continuation of these achievements in great peril. To summarize, the biggest problem is a matter of human resource, and this is about the staff morale. Apart from the numbers, we're talking about staff morale here. Firstly, the shortage of staff. You will notice that we have 250 academic members of staff in the college, serving over 2,000 students, as well as providing service to half of the country and part of the neighboring countries. Our doctors teach at the hospital, but they also teach in the university, but also provide service at the hospital and in the counties. So it is a very lean staff that we would like to see change in. And this lean clinical staff situation is worsened by a perceived discrimination in implementation of national salary awards. I think there were negotiations over the past year where there were allowances that were awarded to clinical staff, doctors in the public service. 1.5 years down the line, the doctors and clinical staff working at Moi University have not received these allowances, despite documentation and representations to our ministry and to Treasury. This has not happened. And we would like Senate to perhaps take up this matter as an oversight issue to ask the executive to implement these changes. And the third challenge is reduced funding to the university. In general, funding to our university has been dwindling over the years, and we have been struggling to look for alternative sources of funding in order to run the very, very important programs that we run in this region and for this country. And finally, laws and regulations, which is, I think, the province of Senate and the province of Parliament. So there are recent developments in respect of immigration and income tax regulations that I will go into a little bit in more detail that are threatening the continuation of our international collaborations in care, in research, and in training. So some of the issues that are peculiar to this college are the issue of allowance of doctors in the public service, as enumerated on page 4 of this memorandum. And this, I cannot overemphasize. I think I'm looking in the crowd and I'm seeing numerous of the clinical staff working at the university who are looking at you, senators, with great hope that you will take up this matter and ensure that their allowances are paid in full and that the arrears since 2017 January are actually factored in. This is something our university management has struggled to follow, and we think that Senate, with the authority that you have, would produce results faster than any one of us could. However, we'd like to request Senate that through legislation or any other way possible, you correct the anomaly such that when these negotiations happen, we don't have to go back and start following in order for them to be implemented for clinical staff. We believe you have the machinery necessary to do this. On the issue of restriction of employment, I'll just make the request to Senate. The details are there. We would like Senate to call for the lifting of the employment freeze in higher education, especially in professional training, and push for increased resource allocation to the universities. Because the universities are the laboratories and crucibles for national development. You starve the universities, you kill the universities, you start developing blindly, and therefore you don't develop. In fact, we say, instead of developing, you devolve. Instead of evolving, you devolve backwards. So the university must be resourced enough in order to guide all national development initiatives. And we're requesting the Senate, through your good offices, you facilitate this. And the second thing on employment, we would like Senate, through the committees on health and the committee on education, because we believe there is representation here that can get the message home, to engage the Commission for University Education to review the appointment and promotion guidelines for doctors, taking into consideration the unique model of their training, registration, and licensing, in order to ensure that teaching in the university attracts the best and the brightest in the profession. The current regime encourages the best and the brightest to remain in the service industry and to avoid the academy. And therefore, you end up with, you know, whatever remains in the academy. And therefore, you tell me about the quality of training, the quality of service that we can offer in training institutions.
Naam, mtazamaji, ili kukuvunjia vunjia na kukueleza kinachoendelea katika eneo la Eldoret ni mwanahabari wetu Patrick Kamimo, utakao tunajiunga naye baadaye kuangalia zaidi hali ya hospital hii ya rufaa ya Moi kule Eldoret iko namna gani. Lakini